beautiful Hera, mother divine, wisest Athena, mighty Poseidon, the Earthshaker, Zeus Artemis, with her deadly aim set to pierce even the heart of a hummingbird, painted pigs, all of them. I see you there. Come closer.
Help me! Someone help! Someone!
None of this is your fault. You're the victim. All the mortals are, made in the bone workshop of fools, jagged reflections from a broken mirror. Behold your god! This one killed 6 innocent children to satisfy her rage. They squabble, burn with jealousy, cheat, fight and murder. They're cruel, vindictive and selfish. And let the heel of Achilles, these witnesses will be their undoing. I have no such flaws. The rest have fallen. Only one stands between me and the rehabilitation of Olympus. Only the foulest, most arrogant, narrow-minded coxer son of Cronos who trapped me beneath the earth. The one and only Zeus!
How I've missed you, Prometheus, my favorite cousin.
You chained me to this rock and fed my liver to an eagle.
Out of love.
Aha. You need my help. Typhon is free.
You once fought beside his allies, the Titans. Convince him to stand down.
It's not that simple. He is even blocking my ability to glimpse the future. I cannot see past him. Go on. Blast me.
I can't! He took my lightning! He took everything! Even the other gods are missing!
Look to the mortals.
That's done. Those evil, imbecilic, tasteless parasites were all turned to stone.
One of those evil parasites is about to save your royal ass.
My ass is safely lodged in the Aegean stables, and mortals will never be anything but a mistake.
Care to make a wager? If I'm right, my sin of stealing fire and ensuring their survival becomes a blessing.
You find your punishment unjust?
It's a little extreme. Do we have a deal?
If you win, I'll end your punishment and set you free. But if I win, you help me stop Typhon, whatever it takes.
Very well. Let the tale of Phoenix be my redemption!
Oh no, not one of your stories. How long is this going to...
My tale begins at sea. A ship of soldiers, returning from a faraway battle. Their victory ambushed by an unexpected storm. The sea tossed and turned, waves churned to a froth. The line between sky and sea all but vanished. The mountainous peaks of the waves descended into valleys nearly as deep as Tartarus.
You're really painting a picture here.
It's an art. Point is, the ship didn't stand a chance. At dawn, the sun rose on the few remaining survivors. The lowest ranked among them, a shield bearer who dreamt of battle, but had seen nary a skirmish.
Wait, don't tell me.
eyebrows. Thick as Narcissus. Has a beard. Like Apollo's chest hair. Body like this. Tan like me at the beach. Skin dark like olives. The good kind, not the green ones. Face like, you know, an face. A face I can see a in sharp my mind. Bird. Hair like, burning. Just burning. Burnt out. Poof. The color, of Poseidon's vomit. Dark as day light.
Wake up!
The storm! Wake up! I have to wake up!
There! I see him clear as day.
The lowest ranked among them. A shield bearer who dreamt of battle, but had seen nary a skirmish. A teller of tales, not a doer of deeds. Phoenix.
What a name! Phoenix! Sounds like the sound a dumb bird makes when it lights itself on fire. Which would be ridiculous. Although,
I should write that down.
Washed up on an unknown shore, Phoenix awoke.
Logos! Captain! Can anyone hear me?
Looks like the only way off this beach is up that cliff.
Phoenix saw his captain and fellow soldiers in the distance. Through a trick of the light, he could almost see them waving and calling to him.
Phoenix! Again! You may not be your brotherly Giron, but I will make something of you yet.
Hold my shield. Try not to drop it this time.
I didn't see you there.
Don't let them get to you. They're just jealous. It's not often someone has a brother like yours.
Lokagos! Lokagos, can you hear me? You've gone cold. What magic is this? Lycaon, where are you, brother?
Unarmed and lost, Phoenix was vulnerable.
I have to be calm. I have to follow my training. My brother's sword! No! Lycaon! Brother! You've always been my hero, my North Star. I will bring you back, I swear it.
Phoenix had never been allowed to hold the hallowed sword. A gift from Achilles for bravery in battle. It balanced perfectly in his palm, as if forged for it.
Achilles' sword? Brother must have been good in battle.
Is something wrong with your voice?
I never got a sword. Just saying.
Phoenix looked up. He was not alone.
By the gods! Stay back!
He readied his sword for his first real fight. Phoenix felt his training come into focus.
We should be able to survey the land from up there.
Unlike the mortal flesh, which had been frozen into marble, the pomegranate sprung forth defiantly, bursting with life.
A lot of poetry for something they're just gonna stick in their mouth.
Isn't that what the best poetry is about?
There's no way across. is the largest statue of Hermes I've ever seen. I wonder who built it.
Besieged by challenge, totally alone, this young hero was determined to save his fellow soldiers and brother.
Boring! Can we skip this part?
No. This is important for the sense of atmosphere.
Hermes, my old friend. It's an honor to finally meet you in person. Just don't tell anyone I'm speaking to you. I got in enough trouble for memorizing stories instead of tilling the soil back at home. And then the other soldiers? Well, they really don't appreciate a good story. Like honey, and the first day of spring, and my first kiss, all rolled into one.
Phoenix got into the ambrosia too? Prometheus!
You worried, Zeus, about losing this bet?
Please, he can't use it anyway.
Yet. Phoenix's destiny was becoming clear.
So far, all you have shown me is a mortal soldier who has fought one real battle, and Typhon grows stronger by the hour. Don't toy with me, Prometheus!
I swear to you that soldier shall be our salvation. For if he fails, and Typhon defeats us, Zeus, King of Gods, the world will fall to chaos.
A temple of Apollo? If it has an oracle or a seer, they could help me undo this curse. A griffin? But they aren't real!
Let me go! Help! Hey! I'll save you! I'm coming!
I need to find a way to reach that rift. how to get down. The pond!
Phoenix felt Ligiron's blade with every step. Its weight a reminder of the heavy responsibility.
You gave him your blade? Oh, Achilles.
I meant to ask, why exactly would you expect to receive a sword from Achilles?
Oh, as an offering. Just a routine offering from someone who gazed into your eyes and told you you were special.
That's all. I left a rose on his breastplate.
Got something in my eye. Keep going.
Done this to you.
Prometheus, stop with the mortal pity party and get to the action part.
Fine.
Now that's more like it.
The adamantine shed by Typhon's minions. Metal of the gods threw itself to Phoenix, as if wanting to be forged into something greater.
Hello? Can you hear me in there? I'm coming! I found your axe!
Phoenix approached the axe, feeling it call to him.
Looks like the axe of Atalanta. It must be a copy. Although...
But before Phoenix could claim it, the axe was pulled into the pit by a terrible force.
Upon my door.
No one.
You think that old trick will work on me? Come into my parlor. Send the Cyclops to the sailor.
Well, that's the end of Phoenix.
Perfectly passable storytelling. I won't lie, there were moments that dragged, but you really got me with that ending. Now, let's settle up. Time for you to help me against Typhon.
It's not over yet. Not by a long shot. What was this strange place?
It's Tartarus.
Just exactly where had Phoenix landed?
Tartarus! The nasty abyss where I imprisoned Typhon. He must have opened rifts into the vaults of the underworld when he escaped. You know it, I know it. Say it!
Phoenix was in Sure.
I hate you!
But aren't you intrigued?
No. Keep going.
You are either brave, little one, or very foolish. Let's see if you can meet my challenge, or if you will fall like all the others.
Who are you? Hello?
Phoenix ran his hands over them, noticing that several pieces were missing, as if someone had ripped them apart.
They seem to be man-made. I wonder how they work, if they even work.
actually work! Sort of. The axe!
The axe of Atalanta. Deadliest of hunters. Swiftest of heroes. Fallen at the hands of Typhon.
Didn't I change her into a lion?
You turned a lot of people into a lot of things.
I need to stop drinking. Bolt of my lightning!
Scattered, hidden by Typhon.
It's over! Phoenix is Helios' ash! No one can handle those bolts but me!
Oh, really?
Gov's uses lightning bolt?
No way!
Power surged through Phoenix. It was too much for him to bear.
What's happening to me?
Bye-bye, mortal!
And then, just like that, it stopped.
No!
The wings grounded the lightning. They were designed to withstand storms.
That shouldn't be possible!
And yet, this is just the beginning. Having plunged into the abyss of Tartarus and living to tell the tale, Phoenix emerged victorious.
For now?
That stranger I was chasing, where did he go?
With the wings, he would be able to flit across the ancient bridge and find out.
I wouldn't just strap on discarded junk. Who knows where those have been?
Many a night, Phoenix had told tales of a genius, an inventor named Daedalus, and his extraordinary wings. Perhaps someone copied their design, Phoenix mused.
So junk?
Ooh. Maybe it's cursed.
I'm coming to help! Hold on!
If only Legiron was here. He's the famous hero, not me. What am I going to do? Put the fiends of Tartaros to sleep with storytelling? Ha! A Gorgon? They're real. What's that glimmering? Maybe if I sneak up on it. These bracers, I've seen them in drawings. They can't be.
Ah, but they were. Heracles, mightiest of mortals, slayer of beasts, defied Hera and accomplished the impossible wearing those bracers. And now, they belong to Phoenix.
Through dumb luck.
Stop! Over here! Fight someone who's armed instead!
So, Phoenix, after boldly besting the Gorgon that ambushed Heracles...
What are you doing there, that thing with your voice?
Heracles?
Yeah, that!
That is how it's supposed to be pronounced.
Seems like a lot of work, but it's your funeral.
Except I can't die.
Don't remind me.
By the gods! I feel like I could lift a mountain!
If only those bracers could move this one.
Hades alive! You two, get a room!
Ha!
The tale of Midas is a good lesson for mortals. Careful what you wish for. He could neither eat nor drink, because all he touched turned to gold.
Lucky gods don't have to eat. I would be rich!
And a good lesson for you would be, not everything is about Zeus.
I'm coming!
How do I get in? If he fell into that vault,
I'll save you! I promise!
So let me get this straight. Instead of heating up the Temple of Apollo to speak with the Oracle, Phoenix is hightailing it after this stranger?
Phoenix, truly a good person, sought to help the mysterious stranger. But he never lost sight of the fact that he was getting ever closer to the Temple of Apollo, and a solution to the terrible curse inflicted upon his brother and fellow soldiers.
Oh yes! Remind me to erase my own faults with narration. Zeus, truly a good person, murdered his first wife by getting her to turn into a fly and then ate her.
Wait, that's what happened to Metis? I thought she was visiting her sister in Babylon.
Oops.
A mark of Ithaca? Odysseus!
More than deft footwork, little one. Let's see if you have control.
Who are you? Show yourself!
Two of the targets seemed easy enough to hit, but the third would require the focus of a master archer.
Forget it! Kids today play seashells, they skip rocks, stare at the wall, you know, they're hyperactive.
This from the god who thinks a week constitutes a long-term relationship.
Keep that steady hand, little one, and you might just survive.
Armed with the agility of Achilles, the speed of Atalanta, the wits of Odysseus, and the strength of Heracles, Phoenix was ready to face whatever the future had in store.
That's it? That's all he has going for him? Pfah! Good luck!
His desire to save his comrades and brother hardened Phoenix's resolve.
Ah, too easy.
Phoenix saw the minions of Typhon had cornered the stranger, leaving no escape,
this would be his greatest battle yet.
Oh, I hope the stranger dies.
It's over. You can come out.
No thanks. I'm good.
There's nothing to worry about. If I had wanted to hurt you, I could just as easily come and stab you back there.
True that. So, I'm going to go.
Phoenix.
Unique name. Appreciate the assistance, Phoenix. Nice bracelets.
Thanks. I'm on my way to the Temple of Apollo. To see the Oracle.
Me too! Ha! It's right over there!
Oh, great! I can use all the help I can get. We should go together. Hey, where did you go? My bracers! That rotten little thief!
I saved you!
I know how you feel, kid. You do everything you can for them, and then they betray you. What's up with that? Who designed that entrance? A circus performer? A magician?
I don't know. Aren't mortals wonderful?
Step forward into the light. The mysteries I have to offer are as infinite as the grains of sand scattered across the floor. What is your question?
Oh, wise Oracle, how do I reverse the curse and turn everyone back from stone?
Wow, that's a real question. I don't know. It's a mystery.
Well, then, how do I get my stolen bracers back?
Ah, another mystery.
Yes, that's why I came to you. The Oracle.
Oh, yes. Well, circling that, I'm just the priest. The Oracle here turned to stone, but the smoke here is something else. Do you think sand? Is called sand because it's between the sea and the land?
Have you seen a little guy with golden hair? No? I'm going to go. What's so funny?
You said the goat twice! But you still haven't left!
My brother was turned to stone, and I can't save him. The one person I tried to help robbed me, and all you can do is laugh.
Whoa! Those are all true. Are you an oracle? Oh, on your way out. Can you pick me up something? I'm starving!
Father of your line is not father of your kin. A mountain crowned with flowing locks is how you win. The monster shambles, hungry for immortal flaws. The true hero owns them all, stolen from the beast's jaws. With the winged herald's aid, go on the attack. And sooner than later, change them all back. A pearl of seas, forge fires lit. A wise child convinced, a feather's weight of wit. Eldest of Thetis, father overthrown. Hero on high, it's time for you to come home.
Now that was a prophecy.
What was? Isn't it weird how prophecy ends with I see? But in this case, I don't?
Stop! Thief!
You can have these bracelets back. You're going to need them where you're going. Come with me.
No!
Look, I'm sorry about stealing from you. It's just something I do, it's
kind of a problem. So, we good?
Not even remotely.
I needed an offering for the Oracle. I thought you were a nobody, and I didn't like your face. But that's all behind us now. We have to go.
Didn't like my...
We don't have much time. He will be here soon.
Who?
I have just a ticket for you to make it to the mainland. Where are those wings?
These?
Now who's the thief? Don't look so smug. They won't fly yet anyway. You have to find the other piece.
What do you mean, fly?
Focus. After that, we need a jar stolen from Aeolus.
It's in there?
I'll go begin the preparations. Meet me at the top of the observatory with the jar.
I don't understand.
You're in grave danger. Help me help you.
Okay, but about what you said earlier. And you're gone. Okay, well, gotta figure out how to get past that barrier.
The labyrinthine path before Phoenix seemed daunting, but the light of endless stars helped show the way.
Guess we now know where Cargo goes to die.
Ah.
You've made it farther than most. Don't worry. I'm on my way to greeting you.
As Phoenix traveled through the underworld, his thoughts turned toward his mother and father. Were they safe in Argos? Had they too been transformed? Phoenix couldn't help.
A huge monster appears! It's ginormous, but Phoenix just laughed.
No! Come to Papa, mother...
No!
So you want to dance, huh?
Oh, it's perfect!
The adorable monster was ever so playful. Everything he had prayed for, to take his mind off his worries. It was a gift from Olympus he would treasure forever, deep within his vulnerable, yet ever-expanding heart.
Ah, fine! Have it your way! Just don't make me vomit!
Phoenix faced the monster, ready. The monster attacked.
Said this was Aeolus's jar. I thought that it would be a jar with the god of winds on it, not in it. This little thing can't contain the wind? That's impossible.
Phoenix looked at the top of the observatory tower. The planetaria could be seen.
Planetary Hubiwati?
It depicts the orbit of planets, and... You know what? Never mind. Continued his journey. He couldn't help but wonder if his story would one day be told amongst the stars.
Hermes always says, the stars tell stories, but I don't get it. It's like I can't read.
Somehow that doesn't surprise me.
Like I'll need to solve this to get to the missing wing piece.
You can't solve the stars. The stars solve you. At least that's what a seer named Miss Clea once told me. And I won't tell you what happened after that. But those stars were bright.
She stole your money.
She did, yes. But I turned her into a juniper berry. So overall, not a bad night.
Ha!
The wall is crumbling. I wonder if there's a way to break through it. Welcome to the Golden Isle, in remembrance of my greatest success and my greatest failure. May the gods accept my offering. May I see you again. Icarus. These are the great Daedalus's wings! He must have built everything here, too. All these temples. I can't imagine losing a son like that. What it does to you.
The wing piece recovered, and Aeolus's jar back from Tartaros. Now, to find that stranger at the top of the observatory.
What? I didn't kill Icarus! Daedalus's faulty wings did that!
And where is Daedalus now? I see. Silence.
I'm sure Phoenix will find out. Eventually.
I thought you said you were preparing something.
Yeah, preparing for you to return. You got the wings?
Yes.
Hey, not really good as new, but what is?
Something new?
You have the jar, right?
Get ready to open it.
What is that?
You deceitful thief! You thought you could escape me?
You stole something from that thing?
I told you, it's a problem.
Tweed, delivery boy. You do not deserve the crown you were given.
We'll take you down, Typhon! Just like before!
We? There is no we! Not anymore!
Phoenix! No! Open your wings!
I can't!
I have you now! You cannot hide forever!
Okay, we need to get to safety. Stat!
What was that monster?
Typhon.
Not the Typhon.
Oh, you have no idea. Gotta get to the Hall of the Gods, then we can talk. You ready to fly?
These were Daedalus's wings. The Daedalus, the great inventor.
So?
So, they didn't work right and killed his son.
He'll be fine. Just don't fly too close to Helios. And also don't try to go to the bathroom during turbulence. You should make it to the mainland without crashing. Probably.
You literally robbed me, and now you're saving me. Why?
I didn't follow most of what the Oracle ran through. But if the prophecy is on the money,
Hero on High,
you're the only one who can stop Typhon from remaking the world.
We don't even know if it's about me.
For someone trying to help everyone right and left, maybe you should accept help once in a while.
What are you talking about?
Fate's alive! How is the Winged Herald supposed to provide aid when you won't let me?
With the Winged Herald's aid? Wait, Winged Herald? No way! You are...
Hermes! I like telling half-truths, playing tricks, and taking long runs on the beach. Now, can we go, please? The other gods need our help.
Other gods? You mean all the stories are real?
Something's wrong with your face. It's doing that slack-jawed thing again. Fly to the Golden Isle. Meet me at the Hall of the Gods. I'll be waiting.
And with that, Hermes disappeared. Phoenix gazed across the narrow band of sea at the peaks and valleys of the Golden Isle ahead. The long path to his true destiny lay stretched out before him.
Wait! That was just a prologue? How does it take someone that long to begin a story? Odysseus made it home faster.
He's about to jump. Be quiet and listen.
Ugh! Ha!